Present this woman to this man to be married.
I'm a heavy one, awesome. The king of my role.
Thank you. Everyone else may be seated, please. Dearly beloved, we gather together here on this wonderful, exciting, lovely, beautiful, cool evening here in Las Vegas, Nevada, in the world-famous Vegas Adventure Wedding Chapel to bring together Fashi and Mona in holy matrimony. Marriage is an honorable estate. It's instituted by God. It's declared by St. Paul to be honorable among all men. It should not be entered into without holy advice or lightly, but reverently, sober, advisably, and in the love of God. I'd like to charge you both on this long anticipated, waited, precious, lovely, beautiful evening here as you stand at this altar in the presence of God to remember that true love and faithful observance of your wedding vows are required as the foundation of a successful marriage and the establishment of a happy and enduring home. Without these, there can be no real marriage, and the home that you two will endeavor to establish will be a vain effort. Keep the solemn vows your young, warm, precious hearts about to meet and connect on this special occasion. Live with tender consideration also with each other. Conduct your lives in honesty and in truth, and your marriage will last. Fashi, Mona, even before God had spoke the world into existence, he had seen that you two would be here in Las Vegas, Nevada, on the last day of January 2008 in the world-famous Vegas Adventure Wedding Chapel, becoming husband and wife. Nothing takes God by surprise. Seeing that you would have King of Rock and Roll, Elvis Presley, singing for you. And he's seen that you would have your special guests out here. He sees the beginning and the ending all at the same time. He has a plan and a purpose for your lives today. You've been chosen, ordained by God from the foundations of the world to live the rest of your lives together as an example to your children, to your family, to your friends, to the community, and to the whole wide world. At this time in the ceremony, we have King of Rock and Roll, Elvis Presley, will sing another song for you. From your heart.
tonight, let you shine. And darling, when I meet again on my own side, love, let us stray from your heart.
Thank you, Alice. In the Holy Bible of the Old Testament, God spoke through King Solomon many years ago in the book of Proverbs, the 18th chapter, the 22nd verse. It reads as following: He who finds a wife finds a great treasure and obtains favor from God. And in the New Testament, in the first book of Corinthians, in the 13th chapter, it's referred to as a love chapter. And as the Spirit of God moves on the Apostle Paul, he begins to write, and this is what he writes from the Spirit of God. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not love, I become as a sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. If I have the gift to understand all mysteries and all prophecies and have faith that I can remove all the mountains in the world and yet not love, it profiteth me nothing. If I give all my clothes and money to the poor and my body to be burned and still show no love, the writer said that this was to no effect, but he did not stop there. As the Spirit of God continually to move up on him, he goes on and he closes out his letter with the man of the gospel, I gladly, joyfully pronounce you husband and wife, Fashi, those who God has joined together, never let no man separate. You now may kiss your wonderful, beautiful wife. One more kiss. Hold it one moment.
Got it. Can't be found. Send home all alone. You can't come around. Hey, at least please, a telephone. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Maybe I've made you think something I might have said.